this topic of geriatric, which has made the reference in this important meeting today, is very important. And we have talked about the national program, Dr. Indraprakash, what is there, and also about the community level, what all work has been done, just what we touched on that, and other aspects of the specialty based. I will like to touch entirely different perspective, and this perspective is based on our 10 to 12 years what we are doing in the field. I am the president of Men's Health Society of India and also doing the age management, and how they are overlapping. They are overlapping in a very peculiar way, and this may be news to many of you. What is the news? That when we talk about above 60 years, what is the population percentage, and when it crosses a particular number, it becomes aging nation. But what is happening in that population? Have you addressed the issue of gender, male and female? We have been talking about feminization of the elderly. What is that feminization is very important. When we are touching geriatric, we cannot avoid that. Do you know that 2/3 of the population in the geriatric group is of female? 1/3 are only male. And if you go above 100 years, only 1 male is 10 females. And if you go above 80, it is 2 males in 8. Where these males are disappeared? Have you thought about that? In the genetic population, where the male population is going? Male is living shorter than female and is suffering more disease-wise. Female is social aspects we were discussing. Female is socially backward today also, and is maybe unemployed. But what is happening when males disappear from the population? Increased widows and unemployed. What is happening in the families, you cannot imagine. Now you try to recollect your own families. Now you see that how many males are alive and how many females are alive in the elderly. And what is happening to male? Male thinks that he is very strong. So I am talking about aging male. And that is the problem. They are missing in the elderly population. In India, male is dying 5 years before female. And in other countries, it is also 4 to 5 years. And in Russia, it is 12 years earlier than female, male is dying. What are the reasons? If you don't address that, then all these programs of geriatric care will not be complete. When we are talking about community, we are talking about education. Medical Council of India in 2012 appreciated that we should start MD medicine. What we are doing in the aging male since 2010, national level, we created the Men's Health Society of India. There is a special chapter of aging male. And why male is more susceptible to disease and mortality, and that is important. The basic is genetically there is a problem. You all should understand, because we have XX Y chromosome which make us male and female, and there are only 50 genes on male X chromosome and 3,000 genes on female. And mostly on the male, they are disease carriers, or they determine the sex. And female, where there are 2X, those who are here from non-medical, female has 2X, male has 1X and 1Y. So having extra X is the luxury. And what is happening, that protect the female. There are telomeres, if you go more detailed, many things are there. They are longer in females, they have no more energy, and all these things are there. Then what is happening? The happening is that male is the endangered sex.
there may be a time this chromosome which is Y is becoming shorter and shorter. In 100 million it may disappear, and that is the danger. You have to see that how the all these things are to be tackled. And now I'll tell you that the mitochondria and all, I'm going at that level. When we are doing bodybuilding, we are burning our stem cells. If you do it extra, you will see those people, they don't live long. You have to do everything in moderation. If you have anemia, I'm not talking about severe anemia, which has become the natural program for female and other. But if it is as anemic, you know that male has more hemoglobin than female. And this less hemoglobin protects the cell, and cell's age is increased. So mild anemia is adding the number of years. Height. You know that Africans, they have height. They are taller. Korean and Chinese are smaller. They live long. So height is the problem. And when you talk about the gender, male is taller than female, average. So male will live shorter. Now coming about the infections. We were talking about infections. When the male child is born, he is 3 weeks male child in immunity is equal to newborn female. So female immunologically is protected, but male is vulnerable to various things. Maybe in premature births, maybe stillbirths, maybe the pneumonias. And you will see that whenever stillbirths are there and there are abortions are there during the gestation, they are more male. Male babies are conceived more, but by the time the baby is born, many of the male child will get aborted. And they are premature, less immunity. And now coming about the other things, when we talk about infections, tuberculosis, have you thought that why it is more in male? HIV, hepatitis C, 2/3 it is in the male and 1/3 only in the female. Stone disease, it is more in the male than female. Cancers, it is more in the male. And what is happening? This all is accumulating, and in aging, it is affecting. In aging, male dies early throughout the life medically. I'm not talking about socially. Medically, male ki won't suffer. And ultimately, this is very important aspect, and I'll like to draw the attention of Dr. Inpal Gash, who has done wonders for this. In last 10 years, when we are talking about this, the gender-specific issues, which are very important, it will upset all the results of your efforts, government efforts, if we are not caring for it. This all started 10 years back. We have the modules. We have 3 levels of training. It is not sufficient that you are only training at the community level. You have to teach at the specialty level, and somebody told that super specialty. So unless 3 level training and 3 level planning is there, these programs, the outcomes are not going to be expedited. They will come, but this, to conclude, we have to, this all aspect which I have told, I'm not going disease wise, but this all is to be kept in mind. And urological care, we are dealing with prostate. 80% of our patients are elderly. We are talking about cancer. Cancer is alarmingly increasing, and prostate cancer is becoming number one male cancer in Delhi. It was 7th in 1996. See that what is happening, and these are the things in the aging population, very important. Thank you.
Thank you. You have, I think, pointed out a very, very important aspect, that is of gender discrimination in the elderly. And like Bobby Grewal was saying, probably the males are paying for their sins.